Hi there, it's Jen from modernmedicinelady.com and the Empathic Woman System, and the word of the day is despite. And it has been one of those days. And I am taking my husband to see the opera tonight, to see La Traviata, which is, it's the one time of the year that we have opera in Maine. And we are going despite the fact that this has been a wacky day. And I was thinking a lot about how incredibly important it is for us to do the things that bring us joy, for us to do the things that are outside of the familiar, that can help us to do a pattern interrupt, to break up the stuff that might be causing a hiccup in our life. And that so often when stuff isn't working the way we want it to, I know for me, especially when I was younger, I'd freeze up like a rabbit, that I would do that thing where I would seize and contract and kind of get all tight and congested and just wait for the thing to pass. But the problem with that is that it doesn't really serve me, because when I'm not breathing, when I'm not relaxing, when I am not allowing myself to look at the positive things, and instead I'm waiting for the discomfort to be over, all I do is amplify my discomfort, amplify my stress, concern, and worry, and generally by doing that, prolong it. And so what I have found is that it is so incredibly important when going through a difficult time to do the things that bring us joy despite the difficulty. Now, certainly there are times in our life where, especially when it comes to grief, trying to do joyful things may be a little bit beyond what we're capable of. But in my experience, when it comes to concern and worry, it is not impossible to step away for a little while and to focus on what brings us delight. So tonight, despite the fact that I got an email this morning telling me that something was not going to be happening when I was hoping it would, and then I had a phone call telling me something else is off schedule that I was hoping would be ready in a few weeks, and then to top all of that off, I also have stuff going on with family members who are going through a difficult time. So today's been an awkward and difficult day, and I could choose to be really stressed about it, or I could do or did what I did, which was I hopped in the shower and I got dressed up and I put on my makeup and I'm ready to go see La Traviata tonight. So my question to you right now is, when you're going through a difficult time, do you focus on delight despite the challenges, or do you find yourself getting caught up in the fear and seizing up and waiting for it to be over? And if you're going through a difficult time, which unfortunately I think a lot of people right now are fairly stressed out, I think there's a lot of stuff sort of in the cosmos that is affecting many people at the moment, what could you do right now that would bring you delight? What could you do despite the fact that maybe some things aren't working quite the way you hoped they would, or maybe they're not working at all the way you hoped you could? What could you do that would help you to focus on something entirely different, that could increase your joy, that could increase your sense of delight, and could help you to break that pattern of concern and worry and maybe freezing up waiting for something to be over, and instead allow you to be in a place of delight and gratitude and enjoyment? So I would love to hear what you have to say about all of this. Please leave a comment below. And until next word of the day, I am wishing you peace, I am wishing you ease, and I am wishing you the ability to experience delight despite whatever else is going on in your life. So in the meantime, please go subscribe to my YouTube channel, Jennifer Moore, Modern Medicine Lady, and also I will be eternally grateful for your help to get this video out into the world. So please like it, please share it, please pass it along to other people who would find it useful. Thank you so much, and until tomorrow and after La Traviata, I'll see you. Peace.